back to the women. This is my next fit tip, and today I'm talking about the foam roller. This is a great way for you to break up the sore muscle tissue and give yourself a massage without actually having to go to a massage parlor. This is what a foam roller looks like. It's a cylinder, and it's foam, so it's really soft, very inexpensive. You can get them at pretty much any sporting goods store, and most gyms carry them. So I'm going to show you today a bunch of lower body exercises that you can use on a foam roller. So we're going to start with the glutes. What you're going to do is just take a seat on the foam roller. I like to put my hands behind me, and then I just roll back and forth to kind of massage the, if you have sore glutes from training. If you want to hit one glute at a time, take your leg, cross it over the other side, and then kind of move to the side, roll back and forth again. We'll hit one side at a time, and then obviously go ahead and do it on the other side. Tip over, and hit the other side glute. To hit the hamstring, you're going to roll backwards. Start to feel it more in the hamstring. The more you lean forward, the more pressure you'll get on the hamstring. You're going to kind of roll it down about halfway. You feel it's kind of like a massage. If you want more pressure, you do one leg at a time. So straighten one leg out, roll back and forth this way, and then obviously do it on the other side as well. You can also do it with your calves. Lift your hips up and roll back and forth on the calves. If you want a little bit more pressure, cross your ankles and do one leg at a time. Kind of twist, hit different angles of the calf. Another one that's really great, it's difficult to hit on your own. A lot of runners will have really tight IT bands, which is the side, the fascia on the side. So you're going to lay on your side this way, put one knee over top, and you're going to roll back and forth this way. This is really, you're going to feel this a lot, so take your time, go slow. You're going to do each one of these about 30 seconds, like 15 to 20 seconds, just keep rolling back and forth. And again, do it on the other side. And then lastly, to hit the front of the quad, on the foam roller, and you're going to roll back and forth this way. To hit the quad, front of the leg, for more pressure, you can use one leg at a time. Roll it to the side. And again, this is really, you feel this a lot, so go nice and slow, take your time, and then do it on the other side as well.
You're doing it kind of slow.
I know that I do a lot of incline walking, the front of my shin feel a little sore, so this is also really good to hit that. This is really difficult to massage, so you can do that. Cross your ankles, one leg at a time for a little bit more pressure. And the last one is for the inner thigh. This is a little bit harder to hit. I like to, you lay on your side, both feet kind of like in an L position. Put the foam roller right by where your knee is. And you're going to kind of roll out this way, back and forth. If you want more pressure, lift your hips off and really push in. Go down as far as you want. Hit a little bit more of the groin and the inner thigh. Just kind of roll back and forth. There you have it. There's a bunch of exercises that you can use to give yourself a self-massage without actually going to the masseuse. Again, this is called the foam roller, and I encourage you to give it a shot. So, until next time, keep living the fit life.